Welcome to Blessed Sacrament Cathedral for this Mass of Monday of the 11th week in Ordinary Time. Happy to have you here with us today in person and on Facebook. We will begin with one verse of "Thou Know We Are Christians," number 735. We are one in the Spirit. We are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit. We are one in the Lord. And we pray that all unity may one day be restored. And now we are Christians by our love. By our love, yes, thou know we are Christians by our love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who are perfect unity and true charity, grant your faithful one heart and one mind, that the body of your church, which rests on the confession of the truth, may flourish in harmony and be made strong in enduring unity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Naboth the Jezreelite had a vineyard in Jezreel, next to the place of Ahab, king of Samaria. Ahab said to Naboth, "Give me your vineyard to be my vegetable garden, since it is close by, next to my house. I will give you a better vineyard in exchange, or if you prefer, I will give you its value in money." Naboth answered him, "The Lord forbid that I should give you my ancestral heritage." Ahab went home disturbed and angry at the answer Naboth the Jezreelite had made to him, "I will not give you my ancestral heritage." Lying down on his bed, he turned away from food and would not eat. His wife Jezebel came to him and said to him, "Why are you so angry that you will not eat?" He answered her, "Because I spoke to Naboth the Jezreelite and said to him, 'Sell me your vineyard, or if you prefer, I will give you a vineyard in exchange.' But he refused to let me have his vineyard." His wife Jezebel said to him, "A fine ruler over Israel you are indeed. Get up, eat, and be cheerful. I will obtain the vineyard of Naboth the Jezreelite for you." So she wrote letters in Ahab's name, and having sealed them with his seal, sent them to the elders and to the nobles who lived in the same city with Naboth. This is what she wrote in the letters: "Proclaim a fast and set Naboth at the head of the people. Next, get two scoundrels to face him and accuse him of having cursed God and king. Then take him out and stone him to death. His fellow citizens, the elders and nobles who dwelt in his city, did as Jezebel had ordered them in writing through the letters she had sent them. They proclaimed a fast and placed Naboth at the head of the people. scoundrels came in and confronted him with the accusation. Naboth has cursed God and King. And they led him out of the city and stoned him to death. Then they sent the information to Jezebel that Naboth had been stoned to death. When Jezebel learned that Naboth had been stoned to death, she said to Ahab, "Go on, take possession of the vineyard of Naboth the Jezreelite that he refused to sell you, because Naboth is not alive, but dead." On hearing that Naboth was dead, Ahab started off on his way down to the vineyard of Naboth the Jezreelite to take possession of it. The word of the Lord. Our response is, Lord, listen to my groaning. Lord, listen to my groaning. Hearken to my words, O Lord. Attend to my sighing. Heed my call for help, my King and my God. Lord, listen to my groaning. At dawn, I bring my plea expectantly before you. For you, O God, delight not in wickedness. No evil man remains with you. The arrogant may not stand in your sight. Lord, listen to my groaning. You hate all evildoers. You destroy all who speak falsehood. The bloodthirsty and the deceitful, the Lord abhors. Lord, listen to my groaning.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I say to you, offer no resistance to one who is evil. When someone strikes you on your right cheek, turn the other one to him as well. If anyone wants to go to law with you over your tunic, hand him your cloak as well. Should anyone press you into service for 1 mile, go with him 2 miles. Give to the one who asks of you, and do not turn your back on the one who wants to borrow." The Gospel of the Lord. This past Saturday, down at the courthouse, there was a rally against the evils of racism. And those who spoke had a common theme, even though none of the speakers rehearsed with each other what was going to be said. And that common theme was about our common humanity. And our need to see each other as part of the whole. So when Jesus is talking today and he said, "You've heard it said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth," I think that the idea of exacting our pound of flesh to get everything we feel we deserve, has been put forth in so many arenas that we have started to see it as the acceptable norm. And there are those in many of those same arenas who would like to play on our fears and try to say to us, something that we have a right to is being taken from us, and we need to fight it. And I think the byproduct of that way of thinking is to look at everyone who is different and to look at with suspicion and an accusatory eye. Jesus goes on to say, someone wants or needs something from you, give it to them, and even more than they need or want. He's telling us that we are fundamentally created to be in service to each other, and there is no distinguishing in God's eyes as to who deserves that service and who does not. One of the challenges that was issued by many of the speaking on Saturday was to find someone who you perceive as different from you and engage in conversation with them. One of the people that was mentioning that said they'd been trying that because they weren't going to profess it unless they had tried it themselves. And they said the most amazing discovery that they made as they were doing that is that more often than not, despite of what they perceived as differences with that person, they found multiple similarities. You know, no matter what race or creed we are, we all have very similar fears and anxieties about some of the bigger questions of life. Regardless of whatever race or creed you are, if you are going to your doctors for your regular checkup, it's a little scary, isn't it? Because you keep waiting to hear them say, which I've never found to be a good thing. But there are so many other realities that are sinned. We all want to make a good life for ourselves and for our family and friends. We all want to get along. We all want peace. We all want to believe in things working out. And yet, if we don't reach out beyond our comfort level, we will be continue to be guided by a mindset that purposefully distances us from those different than ourselves. And then it just seems natural to say, well, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. Our challenge today is to respect each other. And it's interesting, in the first book of Kings reading today, somebody had something that somebody else wanted. They said no. is no respect for that person and their beliefs and their ideas. And the solution was just kill them and then take what you want. There was no respect for the other. So simply put, we are challenged, I think, today to develop that respect for each other to the degree that we start with our common enemy. If you've been following my homilies, I've carried this theme through the last couple of homilies on purpose because I think we're coming to a point where we've accepted divisions as the norm, and they don't bother us anymore. That indeed is a scary reality. So today, let's pray for ourselves and for each other that we see across that which is different and embrace that which is similar and understand that which unites us is our creation. Is part of the communion of humanity, the body of Christ. Let us present our needs to our loving God, confident God will hear them.
For our church, may the Lord increase her in faith, hope, and charity. Let us pray to the Lord. For individuals in positions of authority, may the Holy Spirit guide them in how they use their power and inspire them in protecting the lives of those most vulnerable. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who struggle with addiction, may Christ the physician be with them in their struggles and bring them hope and healing. Let us pray to the Lord. For all of us gathered here, may the grace of word and sacrament deepen our faith and our trust in God. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died marked with the sign of faith, may they come to share in the baptismal promise of new life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord. Loving God, we ask you to hear these prayers and those we hold within our hearts. We ask that you answer them in the name of Jesus, your Son. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, O God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, who renew us in your image through your sacraments and your commandments, mercifully guide our footsteps in your paths, that through these sacrificial offerings which we bring, we may possess the gift of charity for which you have taught us to hope. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father of heaven and earth, for by your word you created the world, and you govern all things in harmony. You gave us the same word made flesh as mediator, and he has spoken your words to us and called us to follow him. He is the way that leads us to you, the truth that sets us free, the life that fills us with gladness. Through your Son, you gather men and women whom you made for the glory of your name into one family, redeemed by the blood of the cross, and signed with the seal of the Spirit. Therefore, now and for ages unending with all the angels, we proclaim your glory, as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said a blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim. again when we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, with all other bishops, with priests and deacons, and with your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the Gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all that, sharing their grief and pain, their joy and their hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation, and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and power and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other, both here and across the way, the sign. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord. The Lord God and the Lord of David, you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be. few would come down the center, and then this side would down that way and come to the center, and then this side would down that way and come to the center by one line coming down.
Amen.
Let us pray. We have received, O Lord, the sacrament of unity. Grant us, we pray, that living in your house in holy accord, we may possess the peace we hand on and preserve the peace we have received through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remind you that Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we have 11:45 Mass here, live, which is open to the public. Friday, the church is closed for cleaning, but the Mass will be live streamed. Saturday, we do not have confession because it's a great day for Greensburg. We're ordaining 5 men to the permanent diaconate. That's a closed service, but it'll be live streamed to the world. Saturday evening, our 4 o'clock Mass, and Sunday, our 10 a.m. Mass will be live streamed as well. So, God bless you all, and have a wonderful day. The Lord be with you. Now, mighty God bless you, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Well, let's sing a hymn. 735 verse.